they faced off today, what do you think would have happened if Fury and Wilder had a face-off?
What?
If they did face off.
I don't know. I mean, maybe nothing. But the chances of something happening and upsetting the fight where everybody has worked extraordinarily hard to put it together, the PBC people, ourselves, the fighters, it would have been a tragedy. So why take that risk? Why? To entertain the circus?
And
you can't get, I'm sorry, you can't get the bridge here for the fight, right? So I noticed on there's a lot of tickets still available for this fight. I mean, you and I talked before the last fight, you thought it was going to do 2 million, it didn't do that number. Why hasn't it resonated with the public, given you have two big giant guys who are big personalities?
Well, first of all, as far as the tickets, yeah,
well, I know for this one,
ticket sales have been very, very good. But look out, walk around town, where are the Brits? Biden has kept them out. They pulled the travel ban starting November 1st. That don't help the fight, right? That's why you don't have the same type of buzz. But I think the pay-per-view is doing better than it did before.
And how will it do in the UK pay-per-view-wise? You know,
I believe it'll do well. I mean, I think it should do good numbers there. It's been really well publicized. And there's been there's a lot of uncertainty about this fight because Tyson has everything to lose and nothing to gain.
Right.
He's beaten him, well beaten him twice. Got robbed the first time and obviously took him to school the second time. But everything's on the line for Tyson and he can't afford to be complacent. I expect him to win, I expect him to stop him, but he cannot afford to be complacent. And it's going to be interesting to see what this guy does. Because for me, he can only do one thing to win this fight, and that's to come out, stand his ground and throw bombs. He ain't going to outbox him. That's the only chance. And if he does that, you're going to get an unbelievable shootout between the two.
Bob, what do you think of the exchange? The last 5 minutes of the press conference were the most exciting when they were actually going back and forth.
Yeah, they said things that really were antagonistic to each other. But words are words. They don't harm anybody. Physical contact, punches can harm somebody. So that's why, particularly with the animosity and what they were saying to each other, right? Certainly they are human beings and each of them are affected by what the other guy is saying. And if you put them together like two dogs, something bad is going to happen. Now maybe it doesn't, but why take that chance?
Thank you, Bob. Thanks, Frank.
It's a pleasure.
Tomorrow we're going to meet all the undercard. That's very exciting for this fight. I'm excited for the undercard, Bob. What can you tell us?
What?
The undercard for this fight.
The undercard is the best undercard on a pay-per-view event that I've ever seen. The three fights, and I mean, we worked hard to put together a good undercard. PBC worked very hard to put an undercard. Those three heavyweight fights are gems. They are really, really good fights. And the Effie... Frank Sanchez fight, 50-50 fight, the Helenis Kowinicki fight, people favored Kowinicki in the first fight, Helenis beat him. That's a terrific fight, very costly fight, but terrific. It is a terrific undercard, and the undercard even leading up to the pay-per-view is terrific. We got the Olympic gold medalists from Cuba on the card on a really good fight. Berlanga's on the card. I know Al has some good fights on the card. I think Williams is on a card. So it's really going to be a terrific, terrific night of boxing.
You know what I love, Bob? That you're working with Al, that you're working with Frank Warren, that you're working with Eddie Hernandez. It's good for the sport. It's good for boxing. And
everybody. We're all promoters. We're all promoters. To silo off our fighters, to not deal with each other is idiocy. We have a lot to offer Heyman. Heyman has a lot to offer us. And now, thank God, everybody is seeing it. Like Eddie Hearn and ourselves. We talk bad about each other. We say things and so forth. But Eddie Hearn is a promoter. He's a legitimate promoter. He tries hard to do a good fight. And if the opportunity is there, why wouldn't I cooperate with him?
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.